What's going on, guys?
Ethan here from DRC TV. Welcome back to another episode. Today, we're running the Epic Bait Molds 5-inch hog mold. This thing is absolutely awesome. The attention to detail was incredible. Kudos to you guys, Jason and Amanda. This thing turned out super rad. We're going to do a little something interesting right now, which is make a bait that is unbelievably ugly and attempt to catch a fish on it tomorrow. We're going to label this as Trash to Treasure Inject to Catch. Basically, what we're going to do is take these two hog molds, just because why make one batch when you can make two, and we're going to use ground or sprue or puck or whatever you want to call it from previous baits that I've made, make them a little bit worse, and then make a three-color bait and attempt to catch fish on it. I'm going to be targeting largemouth, so it's not ridiculously hard, but it's still probably going to be pretty hard. This bait looks terrible, and they're not on beds. So for anybody saying that this would be an easy color to catch a bass on if they're on beds, they're not. The water temp in all the bays is almost 70 degrees, so they're definitely well past that. Tail's going to be chartreuse with blue chartreuse and black flake, and I'm probably going to add something ridiculous like red, or something along those lines. And then the body is going to be white and pink laminate, and the pink is going to be green and black flake, and the white is going to be blue and copper flake, and maybe even giant black flake. I don't know, something ugly. So I'm going to go ahead and heat these up and get back to you when I'm there, ready to inject the chartreuse so that way we can cut the tails off and inject the other portion. Alright, so we got everything heated up. I went ahead and put some red 3.5 hex cut in there. And shoot these so we can get our tail portion out of them. And while those cool, get this twinjector ready to go so that we can go ahead and shoot the laminate on top of the chartreuse tail. If I can find my wing nut, I just work. Bunny walk is off. Just keeping these guys warm while we kind of move around here. Basically, all I'm going to do here is just cut the bait right about there, but I'm going to cut it at a 45 so that way I have more to bond to. Then we need a little worm oil here. Get some of that on our hands. Go ahead and oil these guys up so that they sit back in the mold same way they came out.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to go ahead and just place the other half of the mold back on and try to get everything to line up perfect, which almost never happens the first try, but you can make the attempt at least. We added some 0.35 blue flake and some 0.35 copper flake to the white. Stir that in. Looks like Dunkaroo dip. And then we're going to go ahead and add some giant silver to the pink. It'd be like, yeah, I don't know, 0.65. Maybe 0.125 silver flake. Yeah, that looks ridiculous. Perfect. Go ahead and draw these two up. And make a franken bait. That looks just like Dunkaroo dip, doesn't it?
I don't even know what Dunkaroo dip is.
You don't know what Dunkaroos are?
No.
What? How old are you?
23.
And you don't know what Dunkaroos are?
No.
Holy they're only the best school snack ever that you didn't get at school, like packing your lunch. Your parents, like, you were the shit if you had Dunkaroos. They come in like a little, like, you know, like the cheese spread with the pretzels or the crackers.
Never had them.
What the is wrong with you?
I was poor.
Dude, I was poor too. They're $1 for a six pack. Oh my god. Look up Dunkaroos sometime. Man. That's ridiculous. Yep. That's going to catch them right there. Oh my god. That is so dumb. If I was a crappie fisherman, I would say that is well done. But that right there is the dumbest thing I've ever seen as far as bass fishing is concerned. Maybe if I was bed fishing, but I'm not bed fishing. We're going to go out and give it the good old-fashioned college try with that thing. And I'm going to catch one on it. It might take me a long time, but I'm going to catch one on it. That is a peach. So, the next time you see me, I will probably have a rod and reel in my hand. And I will probably be very, very skeptical on that bait. And I will also probably be panicking pretty hardcore. But anyways, see you on the water. What's going on, guys? We are officially on the water right now. I am waiting for Dawson to get back from launching the boat. Oh man, there's a little bit of wake action going on. Wondering if I can, I'll just hold it, I guess. We are waiting for Dawson to get back from pulling my truck up. He was a gentleman and went and did the nasty walk through the 87 degree, 99% humidity, marshy, crappy woods over there to get back to the launch for me. So yeah, we are at Grassy Point State Park in New York State on the St. Lawrence River. It's up here in Alex Bay. This might be the town of Orleans, but it's pretty much like Alex Bay, Fisher's Landing type area right here on the water. Pretty nice little campground here. There's people all over here. Just had a good conversation with this gentleman. about what the fish are doing, kinda. So we got a little bit of intel to go on. Nothing I didn't already really know, but anything you can get is better than nothing. I think we're gonna head towards Clayton direction and see if we can't find some largemouth on our super killer, whatever we were calling the color, Trash to Treasure Inject to Catch bait. That grease monkey is gonna be a challenge for sure. That is to say the least. And I'll catch up with you when I'm fishing next. Show you the rig we're gonna be throwing. All right guys, so we got our like strawberry kiwi yogurt thing going. I'm gonna just throw this on a 4-aught regular worm hook. Not a big fan of EWGs, but use one if you feel so inclined. Just a standard sliding Texas rig, 3/16 weight. We're gonna flip some knots.
Oh man.
Well, guys, we gave it our best effort. I really like. We could have gone other places probably, you know, thinking after the fact, we probably could have gone to Lake of the Isles or maybe gone to an inner lake and done it that are like predominantly largemouth inhabited, but we were hoping that it wouldn't take that long and we could go out and crush some smallmouth after the video. Well, it took the whole time. I don't know if we got it on video or not, but I did lose like a 4-pounder about halfway to the boat. I buckled into it and fought it for a second, come up, jump, spit it. And I had a couple bites that I know were bass that I missed. Just kinda is the way it is, you know, you work really hard for that fish that's already hard to catch, and then you throw that thing at them, and they're kind of just hitting it out of instinct and spitting it right back out. They don't know it's food. It's a reaction strike. But every time I got bit, I'd go into the dock and investigate. I could see bass swimming away, you know, tucking under boats, tucking in the dock corners or whatever. You know, if I had the ambition, I probably could have swapped out to a green pumpkin or something and thrown in there and caught the fish. But I was just really dead set on pulling a fish out on that bait, and it just never happened. But I did have fun. I think that there's a little bit of learning that was kind of enveloped in today's video. I did figure out that
there are certain docks that this time of year don't hold fish that I have had success in the past that I kind of just went to because I've caught fish there in the past and they just don't have fish on them. And then I also found docks that do have fish on them this time of year, which was pretty nice. I did a lot of flipping, like definitely did close to 500 flips to no avail. But we got close, and I think that counts halfway. Like, if you can give me enough credit to say, like, at least I got bit. Like, it definitely got bit. It's just, I didn't put anything in the boat. So, you know, if we're talking trophies, talking money, no dice. But for YouTube, that's enough dice for me. That's enough to put in my Yahtzee cup. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. It probably isn't the longest video out there, you know, and it's obviously not full of the most intense content, but maybe take an idea from what you see in the video and use it elsewhere. Right now they're post-spawn heavy, so they're just kind of laying up just outside of their bedding areas and just sitting there, but we did get a couple to eat, which was cool. And we got to see some people along the way, you know, talk to some guys like Ernie that I haven't seen in years. That was really cool. Nice to talk to him and catch up and whatever. And I had a good time because I was out on the water. We went out this morning and did pretty good on the smallmouth. So I'm satisfied as far as fish catching goes. Make sure that if you liked this video and you enjoyed it, you want to see more of it, hit the thumbs up. I actually pay attention to like how many thumbs up I get on every video and then kind of correlate the content to that. This is just trying something new. So just do me a huge favor, hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed this, so that way I know whether to continue making videos like this, doing different challenges. I mean, we can go to different bodies of water and throw different stuff for fish that typically shouldn't eat that, and see how we do. And if you have any questions or comments or concerns, you know, as far as why I did what I did, what types of structure I was targeting and all that stuff, a little bit more in depth, hit me up in the comments section. I love hearing from you guys. I love answering any questions that you guys have. And please be sure to subscribe to the channel. Subscriber count is really important to me. We're trying to kind of make this happen. And plus, at 800 subs, I'm doing a pretty sick giveaway. So yeah, just, it would mean a lot to me if you became one of my subscribers today. So all you gotta do is just click that link. And if you want to get notified anytime that I post a video, just hit the little bell icon and it'll send you an email, I think, every time I upload a video, so that way I'll never miss anything. Had a really good time today, and tight lines as always. Peace out.